ideas. The last class we studied about the thief. The lesson, the thief. I think everybody enjoyed the story and you read it very well. Okay? Yeah. After completing the lesson, we should study some words also. While we study the unit, we also studied some new words. By studying such words, what you should do? You should try to use it in your own sentences. Then only your vocabulary will increase. So here, first we had to study some word power. Now let us move on to our word power. During the time of lesson also, you have already understood the meaning of some words. By using such words, whenever you see any other situation, how can you utilize it? That is the very important thing that you study word power. So here, fill in the blanks, page number 21 onwards. Fill in the blanks in the sentence that follow with the appropriate choice from the brackets. Some words will be given in the brackets. And from that words, you should fill up the blanks. Which word will be suitable in that context? According to that only, we should fill it up. So the first one, when I arrived at the party, I found that everyone was dressed in formal clothes. And I felt very rich in my torn jeans and purple t-shirt. That is the first one. Here, suspicious, conscious, conspicuous. Three words are given. Which may be suited for that situation? Suspicious. Will you be suspected that time? Suspicious during that time? All others came with the well dressed. And you are only in the torn jeans and purple t-shirt. Then you will be conscious or conspicuous. You will be conscious during that time. Conscious. That is the first answer. Conscious. So the correct answer is conscious. During a holiday, I like to leave the noisy city and go to a more lush place in the hills or by the ocean. Here, three words given: tranquil, traditional, transit. Whenever you are in a noisy place, sometimes you will irritated from that. You will feel something irritated. Then what will you think? You had to save there only, or you had to be there only, or do you want to move away from there and to be in a calm and quiet place? Yeah, you will be. You would like to be in a calm and quiet, peaceful place. Which word will be suitable here? Tranquil. Tranquil. So, during a holiday, I like to leave the noisy city and go to a more tranquil place. Tranquil place. And the next one, the workers were offered a generous bonus as days to complete the project sooner. The workers will be given something extra as a generous bonus. What we will call the, that is a payment. Payment means always giving, or incentive, or an assurance. Generous bonus as an incentive. As an incentive. The fourth one. The wealthy businessman. I-N-C-E. Incentive here is E only. Incentive. The wealthy businessman was known for entertaining guests dash in his penthouse apartment. Luxurious people, how they will spend their money? Very rich person only, they don't know the value of money. So what they will do? Somebody know the value, but they spend their money lavishly. They are spending their money lavishly. Lavishly. The manager dashed my soft nature by giving me extra work, knowing that I would not refuse. The manager exploited. Manager exploited. Manager exploited. Sixth one, I am looking for a new internet provider as the current service is not consistent. It works in starts and stop, fits and start, stop and start. Internet provider current service is not consistent, so it should be fits and starts. Fits and starts. Fits and starts. Seventh one, during the debate on TV, my opponent tried to dash by bringing up irrelevant matters of a personal nature. Put me in my place, put me out of my stride, put me on the ground. Put me out of my stride. Put me out of my stride. The last one, not having much to do during the summer holidays, we dash various malls. During the vacation time, there won't be much to do. So what you had to do? You have to just hung around various malls, or hung in onto the mall, or hung inside the mall. Inside the mall, or as onto the mall, or around the mall. Just hung around. Just hung around. You hung around the mud. So my dear, look at here, all of you. These are the words you have already studied. And now these 8 words you have already used in your fill up the blanks. And what you have to do, by using all these words, you should find out some sentences and make your own sentences. Have you understood this one? Now we have to move on our next part. That is concrete noun. Here in the last class, in 7th standard and all, you have already studied. Lower classes you studied about the noun. And when you grown up, some other classes, you studied the different parts of noun, different kinds of noun. Different kinds were there. And now you are going to study about concrete nouns. What is concrete noun? Concrete noun. The concrete noun. What is noun? We have already studied it. What is it? Noun is the name of a person, place or thing. And studied about abstract noun also. What was it? Abstract noun have no color, size, odor, smell, etc. Collective noun, group of people, animals and things. They are called collective noun. And now you have to study about concrete noun. What is it? Concrete noun Describe specific personality type. What is it? Concrete noun. Describe specific personality type. That means a specific personality. Concrete nouns are the nouns or the words that describe about the specific personality type. So different types of persons are there, and among that, specifying the personality, some words we are using, that words are called concrete noun. And abstract noun we studied, no? Sound, color, smell or anything. Here some words are given. Just you look at it. These are the examples of concrete nouns. I will read it. Mercenary, entrepreneur, pauper, novice, penitent, tycoon, altruist, protagonist, Scrooge. All these are the words used to describe about the person, specific personalities. So these words are called concrete noun. So how to use this? All these are about, we always heard that he's a Scrooge. Why do we say so? Because we have already studied the story of that person, and its character, that person's character, if you see in any other person, we will tell he's Scrooge, he's like Scrooge only, but we will say he's Scrooge. That personality we will tell them. So here, Deepak, the narrator and main character of the story, can be described as the dash of the tail. Dash of the tail. Tail means a story. So what may be the Deepak? We studied about the character and the story. The thief, we studied about whom? Deepak. So here's the main character of the story. Here's the protagonist. Who's a petty thief, but as he claims to have a lot of experience, he is not a, which one will be suit the, he will be a novice. At his state, however, he has not had much luck for some time, and unlike the rich man he refers to in his narration, is currently a pauper. P-A-U-P-E-R. A pauper. He hopes to improve his financial situation by exploiting Arun. We are not told what Arun does for a living, but as he keeps losing and making money, he could be an entrepreneur. Who spends money as if he is a business tycoon. He likes people in general and like an altruist. Would be glad to help those who are in need. As he is generous with his money, he cannot be described as a Scrooge. Deepak initially appears to be a person who would do anything for money? A complete mercenary. Complete mercenary. But later he feels guilty about robbing Arun, and so when he returns to Arun's home, he does so as a true penitent. True penitent. So look at these words: protagonist, novice, pauper, entrepreneur, tycoon, altruist, Scrooge, mercenary, penitent. All these are the examples of concrete noun. What is concrete noun? Concrete noun are the words used to describe or the specific personality. Describe about the specific personality. The person's character we will imply here, and such words are called concrete noun. So what you should do? You should write these words and try to write some sentences by using these words. Have you understood? Okay. Thank you.